I mean, I woke up in the middle of the night with an incredible case of vertigo. You know, the room was spinning. I wanted to throw up.
Mark Polymeropoulos, a former U.S. intelligence officer at the CIA, was hit in 2017 by an invisible attack in a Moscow hotel.
I'd been in places like, you know, Iraq and Afghanistan. I'd been shot at, but this was by far the most terrifying experience of my life.
It's a mystery that's plagued the U.S. intelligence community and the State Department for years. An attack which brain experts now say was likely the result of a microwave weapon, hitting American personnel in Cuba, China, Russia, and other places around the globe. The U.S. government has not identified the perpetrator, but current and former U.S. officials believe Russia is to blame. The Russian government did not respond to CNN's request for comment. The attack impacted his balance, sight, and hearing. The pain has never wholly subsided.
I couldn't, you know, make it through the day, not even close. I've had a headache every day since that night in Moscow. It's never gone away, day and night.
He had to retire early. And for a dedicated CIA officer who spent his entire career fighting terrorists in the Middle East, it hasn't been easy to accept that an invisible strike took him out of the game.
I rather would have been shot. This was a silent wound. You know,
You would have rather been shot?
Absolutely.
Why?
Well, I mean, it's something that I could have shown people. I had a really hard time initially at the agency because people didn't necessarily, the senior medical staff didn't necessarily believe me.
Polymeropoulos had to fight to get expert health care. Just this month, he finished specialized treatment at Walter Reed Medical Center, more than 3 years after that traumatic night in Moscow.
When they provided me the piece of paper with the diagnosis that said I had a traumatic brain injury, you know, I had tears in my eyes.
Some 40 U.S. government officials have experienced symptoms similar to his. In 2017, the U.S. Embassy in Cuba slashed its staff because the attacks were so pervasive. A newly declassified State Department report points to systemic disorganization when the department began handling this crisis during the Trump administration. New Hampshire Senator Jeanne Shaheen has been fighting to get the victims medical assistance and answers about who did this.
If we don't hold those responsible accountable, then we can be sure it's going to continue to happen. And that's a national security risk to the United States and to our personnel.
According to U.S. intelligence documents obtained by CNN, Russia has been developing this microwave attack capability for decades. Today, Bill Burns, President Biden's nominee to lead the CIA, telling Congress,
I will have no higher priority than taking care of people, of colleagues and their families. I will make it an extraordinarily high priority to get to the bottom of who's responsible for the attacks.
Polymeropoulos created a Superman mask in art therapy, thrusting a dagger through Superman's skull to represent the headaches which have changed him. The CIA agency seal cracked. His family was emotional when he showed them his project.
My son and my daughter both said to me, you know, Dad, you're still my Superman.
Before the attack happened, how would you describe your relationship with the agency in, you know, one or two words?
It's a love affair.
And after?
A divorce. With perhaps some reconciliation in the future, I would hope.
Now, Jake, I have just learned from a U.S. official that the CIA has set up its first ever task force in recent months to handle these suspected microwave attacks. And the official explains to me that they are going to use the breadth of resources at the CIA. And this process is going to ensure that there is a team and process in place to address any future incidents. We should also note that the CIA spokesperson, Timothy Barrett, said the agency's top priority has been and continues to be the well-being of their folks who are out in their field, of the intelligence officers. But this is something that we are going to stay on because this truly needs to be a whole-of-government approach if the process is going to work here and if those who are hit are going to get what they need.